Dr. Rob here, and we're going to be talking about some tips and tools that you can do to improve liver function and enhance liver function. And when we look at that, we got to understand like why it's so important to enhance liver function. Well, if we just look at the word liver, what's inside of it? It's the word live, right? It's the word live. So liver function is so important. And guys, if you're just hopping on with me, quick favor, if you got a health problem, you got a weight problem, you're curious, is it due to a toxicity? I created a really cool toxicity questionnaire. You just click on the link above. It'll take you to the website. You fill out the toxicity questionnaire. I also teach you on there a bit about how to do a warm water cleanse. You could learn about warm water cleansing on the above link, as well as you could take the toxicity questionnaire. It's cool stuff. In any event, so liver, what does it do? It has over 500 different functions, balances our hormones, helps us burn fat, helps improve thyroid function. The liver actually activates, here's a crazy thing, your liver activates your fat burning hormones, meaning like your thyroid makes thyroid hormone. It's not really active. The liver activates it so it can burn fat. Your pituitary gland makes growth hormone, not really active, has to make it to the liver. The liver then activates it so it can burn fat. Balances your neurochemistry, gets rid of poisons, gets rid of toxins, helps create specialized substances to improve your joint health. So the liver's a busy organ. It does a lot of stuff. Joni Ryan, you helped me come back from liver shutdown. Oh, well, Joni, you're welcome. Thank you very much for being here. Joni, I'm going to show you some really cool tips in a minute. I just want to let people know about liver enzymes. Rest of you guys, if you're on, give me a quick little shout out. Give me a hey, give me a hello, make sure I can hear you. So what do you do, right? So what are some cool things you could do to enhance liver function that maybe you're not doing? Well, let's take it outside and I'm going to show you. So the first thing that you could do is get outside, get your shoes off, and get on the ground. Now, why do you want to get outside and get on the ground? Like, what's the big deal with that? Well, let's go outside right now. I got the sun beaming on me. It's hot out here. Let's get some sunshine and let's see why this is important. Well, when we get out here on the grass and we start walking in it, I'm gonna kick off my flip-flops here, if I can get them off. When we start walking on the grass, what we're doing is we're doing something called grounding. What's grounding? Well, the grass, the earth down here, it actually has a charge. So this stuff down here that I'm gonna get in, hey Giovanni, here's my doggies. There's my pooch, there's G. What's up, buddy? So this stuff down over here, what's up, Giovanni? Come here, bud, come here. This stuff down here, you know, dogs innately know this stuff, right? Dogs kinda wanna hang out on this stuff. This earth here, it has a polarity, it actually has an electrical charge. And when your body is on this, like my hand is on this, when you're on this, the energy, the negative ions, which are good, from the earth, it literally comes up into your body. These interact with, they literally interact, and I'm going to tell you about a study in a second. They literally interact with chemicals in your body that would cause DNA damage. Here's what we know. So there was a study that was done in the Journal of Environmental and Public Health, and they found that grounding, and I'm going to show you some other ways to ground. They found that grounding improved sleep. It improved your circadian rhythm, meaning when you went to sleep, when you woke up, which can increase your energy production, increase your sense of well-being. It decreased pain, and it increased overall functionality of a person's body. So this is a way of enhancing body function that most people aren't doing. You're getting in touch with the earth. Really simple. What do? Go to a beach, go to your backyard, go to, great for jet lag too. Yes, it is, Brandy McRae. You were right, great for jet lag too. But what are you doing? You're actually just getting out, right? And you're just putting yourself in contact with the earth. You can walk and do that. You can lay in the grass, play with your pets, get outside and throw the ball with your pets, take a walk, take a stroll. There's a million different ways you can do that. You want to make sure if you are walking in your backyard that you're not walking in an area where your pets poop, because sometimes pets carry parasites. The most common one that they'll carry that affects you when you're walking is going to be hookworm, which they get in through the bottom of your feet, and you don't want to get that stuff. That's not cool. So what are some other things that we could do to enhance liver function that's really cool, real important? Well, let's check it out. Here's some other stuff. All right, how many of you guys drink water? Hopefully everybody drinks water. Let's take a seat and let's see what I got here. All right, how many of you guys drink out of this plastic water bottle? Oh, I hope not a lot. So here's the problem
And I'm going to tell you, if you're going to drink out of a plastic water bottle like this one here, you want to make sure it is BPA free. I'm going to tell you what to do as an alternative and why this is not so great and what you could do that's a lot better. But here's the deal. If you're going to drink out of a plastic water bottle, I do recommend Fiji. I think Fiji is the, in my opinion, from the analysis I've done, Fiji water is really the best water that you can get. And it's great for liver health. And the reason why is the pH that this is created at, which is about 7.7, 7.8 roughly, the pH is really good for that, for your liver. For the liver, we want a slightly alkaline pH. Your liver makes bile, which is very alkaline. So to enhance liver function, we do want a slightly alkaline water. However, drinking from plastics is problematic. And high alkaline water is, I'm sorry guys, those of you that are alkaline water drinkers, is not good for your body. It places a massive stress on your body when you drink high alkaline water. Your blood pH is between 7.3 and 7.4. And when you drink water that's like a 9, a pH of a 9 or an 8.8 or a 10, you're pushing your body into what's called alkalosis. Your body has to do a whole bunch of crazy things. It's very stressful to try to bring your body pH into normal. So high alkaline water, I do not recommend it. I don't think it's beneficial for you. I think it actually can cause harm to a lot of people. However, a water like this where the pH is 7.7, if you're going to drink out of plastic and you don't really have a choice, pH like this from Fiji is definitely, I think, is going to be the best. 7.7 pH, that's great for your liver. It's also made from BPA-free plastic, which means it doesn't have that toxic compound that's very stressful on the body that you find in plastics. Now, you are going to find phthalates in this stuff, which is an endocrine disruptor. You're welcome, Brandy. Which is an endocrine disruptor. So we don't want to get endocrine disruptors in our system, and plastics unfortunately have that. Now here's the deal. It's not a problem to drink out of plastic for a few minutes. The problem drinking out of plastic comes when the plastic is left in a certain area. And guys, if you're just hopping on and you're wondering, do I have a toxicity? Is toxicity my problem? Go to the link above. Go check out that link. I teach you how to use warm water when you're cleansing, like a warm water cleanse, on that page, as well as you could take the toxicity questionnaire that's right on that page. Just click on the above link. You could take the toxicity questionnaire and you can go ahead and learn about doing a warm water cleanse, which is really neat. So what do I use? I like to use this. This is a glass water bottle. It's got a little little neoprene sleeve. And this water comes from a reverse osmosis machine upstairs in my kitchen, which pulls out everything. It pulls out parasites, heavy metals, toxins, environmental pollutants, pulls out all the junk. And then ideally you want to get what's called a remineralizer, which adds minerals to your water. When you're using a reverse osmosis system, the problem is it pulls out everything. So you're left with just water, pH 7.0, no minerals at all. And that's not good, because if you drink just plain water with no minerals in it, one of the things that can happen is your body will start to leach minerals from your bones and from your muscle tissue to make up for the missing minerals that are in the water. So you'll actually start to create mineral deficiencies in your body if you're just drinking pure distilled or reverse osmosis water. So I don't recommend that. But if you have a remineralizer on the end, which is cheap, you can go ahead and the remineralizer adds minerals to the water. It bumps the pH up to about 7.8, which is great. And you got good minerals and you drink it in this guy right over here. So that's a good thing you could do. What's another great thing you can do? Well, we got some grounding that I talked about. We got drinking out of plastic. If we're going to drink out of plastic, we go BPA-free plastic. Use Fiji water if that's the direction you're going to go. The other thing you can do right here, gang, what's this? This right here is a green drink. And in there, you're going to see cruciferous vegetables. So these cruciferous vegetables here, they add something to the liver. It's a sulfur compound that really aids the liver in its ability to do what's called phase 2 detoxification. Your liver has two stages of detoxification, phase 1 and phase 2. Now, here's a crazy thing. Most people don't know a whole lot about this, so I want to take a second because this is really important and really why you guys need to be consuming this right here, cruciferous vegetables, and why these are so important. Phase 1, your body takes a toxic compound from the environment. Like, let's say it's mercury. We'll just use that common one. well, it's common, but it happens. So your body takes mercury or takes whatever toxin and it turns it into a more toxic compound, meaning in stage one liver detoxification, your body's taking a toxin and making it way more toxic, like a million times more toxic. In stage two, your body's taking that super toxin and making it completely not toxic, like it's totally getting rid of it. So phase two is really important. And the reason why is because phase one makes these super, super crazy toxins that really can destroy your body and damage your health, right? So the cruciferous vegetables, again, these guys right here, they provide sulfur that aids in phase two liver detoxification. They also unburden the liver and remove stress from it. But those cruciferous vegetables are gonna be key. You wanna have them every day. Kale is going to be probably the best one depending upon what you're trying to do, but kale, cauliflower, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, bok choy, these are all wonderful cruciferous vegetables and additions you could utilize to help your liver and get it functioning properly. So, okay. Now, if you guys have questions, please post them down here. I'm happy to answer questions about your liver, about health, anything like that. Please let me know.